The effects of COVID-19 has certainly left a wake of destruction in its path. And with the hit of the second wave, it certainly seems to be closer to home than ever. We chat to infectious disease specialist Dr. Emil Reed on his own personal experience with COVID-19 and what he learned beating the virus. We also have Nicole Austin joining me in the loft again today as the health correspondent. It's great to see you again, girl, and we're even matching.
I know. Did we get the memo or did we get the memo?
I know, but this is what it's all about, you know, bouncing back and forth ideas, especially when it comes to COVID-19. Now is the time, second wave has hit, so let's get educated.
Absolutely. I think green is indicative of health and life, and certainly no one could celebrate that more than Dr. Emil Reed.
Absolutely. And speaking about Dr. Emil, I mean, welcome back to the show. We often have you on the show sharing your own knowledge on disease and COVID-19. And now recently, you were unfortunately a victim of COVID. So tell us about your own personal experience.
Thank you very much, Belisa. I think the most important thing, like many other families around the world, me and my family have also been affected by this horrible and terrible disease. Myself, having chronic underlying illnesses and taking immunosuppressive treatment, this illness nailed me to the bed. The experience was scary and not really what I was used to, being in the bed and not beside the bed. During the initial few days, my wife Fatima cared for me until my oxygen levels started to drop and I became extremely short of breath at that moment in time. I was lucky to be surrounded by amazing friends who treated me and managed my complications. The physical impact was huge, but the psychological impact was even worse. I developed severe anxiety, struggled to sleep, and I was unsure whether I'll be able to get back into my working environment again, and that is to care for the sickest of the sick. I seek psychological help to assist me to heal emotionally before I could return back to the front line.
Well, doctor, I can attest to that. I have had COVID myself and had it inside my home. And I think being a medical professional, you have this logical approach, but then you also have this fear and anxiety associated with COVID-19. How do you balance that? And how does this affect your living environment with your family?
Well, it was a horrible time, Nicole, as you can imagine. And because we are a close-knit family, and I mean myself being a warm individual, loving to hug people, etc., it had a massive impact on my life. We unfortunately had to rearrange the household and the functions at home, and we were quite strict with regarding the specific system we put in place in order to prevent transmission of this horrible virus. So quite scary experience, and always worried about the fact that I can actually contract the bug myself and take it to my family at home. Fortunately, both my wife and my kids was asymptomatic and also tested negative for SARS-CoV-2.
Now I'm very curious to find out, you know, as medical professionals, both of you, I mean, Nicole, as a pharmacist and yourself, doctor, how you both then dealt with COVID-19? How did you focus on healing, beating the virus? And have you experienced any post-COVID symptoms?
Indeed, Belisa, for me, the most important thing was to apply the mitigation strategies in order for us to prevent further transmission. And the most important thing was to carry on, to stay active, to mobilize, to make sure that I do not develop any signs or symptoms of blood clots, because as we know, COVID-19 can induce hypercoagulability, meaning that your blood becomes thick. You can develop blood clots to the lungs, to the brain, and also in your calves. So I needed to stay active. Because of your smell, your taste, and your appetite being poor, you actually don't feel like eating. I had to continue eating. And my main source, for instance, of nutrition were smoothies, low sugar, low carbs, but in all likelihood, getting all the nutrition through ginger, through garlic, vitamin C, vitamin D, zinc, selenium, as far as possible. And the one thing that pulled me through and carried me through this whole ordeal was the constant reminder of my young family, my wife, my kids, and also my patients, expecting my return and expecting me to be back in order to assist them. Even after I was released and came back to work, I still battled with post-COVID symptoms, which took round about 3 months to completely go away. Niggling headaches, shortness of breath intermittently, chest pain, and joint aches. So the so-called long COVID is an absolute reality.
Yeah. Well, Doc, I don't think people actually realize, you know, how close you came and how you had to fight for your life. I certainly didn't have it that bad, and I learned to become more self-aware. But this virus takes you into a place of such fear, and that makes people selfish. And I think certainly to see your attitude is inspiring, that you want to focus on your patients and you want people to focus on not making other people sick. So what are any of your other personal do's and don'ts that you could share with us?
Nicola, I think the most important thing for me is to take this illness seriously. It happens to all of us. Never think that you and your family are immune to COVID-19. Never rest on your laurels that you've been doing everything that is expected of you and that you did everything to protect yourself. Rather be paranoid than to be blasé or relaxed about it, because it's not just about you as an individual, it's also about those people that are at high risk to die and those people that are at high risk to develop complications, like our parents and our grandparents. COVID-19 doesn't care who or what you are or even what your age is. The important thing is follow the science and listen to the scientists. And not everybody on social media knows what they're talking about. So stick to the science. Mask up, physical distance, sanitize, and probably number 4 for me, get vaccinated at the first opportunity you can, because I believe that is the only way out of this pandemic for all of us.
A crucial conversation that we're having here today. Thank you so much, Doctor. And of course to you, Nicole, for not only sharing your personal experiences, but also as people within the medical fraternity, helping us understand how you survived. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, guys.
Now, do you have a survival story? Then we want to hear from you. Share your survival story with us, from surviving a failed parachute to escaping a lion attack. We want to hear your story. Imuenza is giving away 5,000 Rand a week for 5 weeks. All you have to do is reply to the Imuenza competition post on the Afternoon Express Facebook page or Twitter page and tell us your survival story and what protected you. Using that hashtag, Imuenza, competition closes on the 24th of February 2021 at midnight, and terms and conditions can be found on afternoonexpress.co.za. Support your immune system for your next big adventure with Imuenza.